So having tuna 10 ways at Marina, I thought that would be the end of it. But Carmina brought me to another tuna place. Hi, Carmina.
Hi, Chef Claude. How was your lunch today with
It was
Carlo?
Great, it was great.
Here we go on another tuna adventure, but more on the interesting tuna parts.
Wow, that sounds great.
Yes, so we're here at Yellowfin. Let's go.
Okay, sige, tara.
Chef Pao, this is
Hello.
Pipa Angeles.
Hi, Pipa. Oh, thank you for having me here.
No, pleasure. Have a seat.
Thank you. Right. Wow, what is that? It's still sizzling hot.
Yeah, so this is a seafood platter.
Yes. Yeah. So and all kinds. Is this one of your bestsellers?
Yeah, it is definitely one of the
bestsellers.
This is basically the ubul-ubul.
Ubul-ubul, what is it?
Yeah, I think
I believe it's the esophagus.
Esophagus?
So,
it looks snappy.
It has like a texture of
It's squid-like texture. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's chewy.
This is the first time I'm encountering the ubul-ubul.
That's one of my favorites out of all the tuna parts because I like the texture.
This is good.
It's chewy.
Chewy like the cuttlefish, like the squid. But it's fatty. The texture is like the squid.
Yeah. So much more tender. Well, are you the only one who pretty much serves the ubul-ubul? I think so, right?
Honestly, no, it's becoming really common nowadays. Now that Davao is getting so well known, everyone's basically becoming curious about Davao. The bagaybay. And that's my personal favorite. It's the exact opposite of the ubul-ubul. It's soft and juicy. It's a lot softer.
Charred on the outside. But soft and tender.
Do you like it?
Earlier. Marina has the tuna 10 ways, but somehow this is not a repeat. I mean, although I had the tuna belly, I had the sperm sack as well, but this one I did not have, the ubul-ubul. But I think it's the timpla, meaning the marinade, something in it.
And it's really simple and not too overpowering. Yes.
The main ingredient speaks for itself. I mean, it has to be, it's super fresh.
Tell me about Yellowfin restaurant. How did it start and when? Who founded it?
Well, it was my dad, definitely. It started way back early 90s as a carinderia.
Carinderia?
Like literally, really? Named Carinderia with a K. We had a steakhouse, but not everyone could afford steaks. One of my dad's friends basically advised him, why don't you open a cheaper restaurant? So basically, as it turned out, mas malakas yung carinderia.
And the imbao,
from
what I know, right, is really unique to the Davao Gulf. But normally when we eat it here, we make it normally into a soup.
Yeah,
with ginger. But I like how you made this because it's just also simple and plain. And, I heard the sizzling of the platter earlier and I love that sound of the sizzle.
It just exploded in my mouth. The flavors. The flavors of this. Yeah.
And it's really juicy and tasty, yes. When I think about the food in Davao, we're all about the simplicity. And you can't overdo it, you can't overcook it, you can't put too much spices because it's going to overpower it. Which hindi mo ma-appreciate yung freshness.
The freshness of the food.
Yeah, that's basically yun yung importante sa plato mo, how fresh it is.
What is the Davaoenos choice of salting ingredient?
They don't cook much with patis here.
Patis is very Tagalog.
Yeah, it's very Tagalog.
So it's
soy sauce and salt. And then obviously there's always the suka.
And sili.
And
suka.
Suka
so again, the salty,
basic.
Sour, acidity from the suka or calamansi.
Yes, balances
and then the
everything.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bagay-bagay lahat.
Yeah.
Ubul-ubul.
Yeah.
I mean, what binds it together? I think your secret sauce.
It's probably the secret sauce.
It's so good.
Yeah.
No,
thank you. I'm glad you liked it.
Before I get some more food, I'd like to thank you for serving me this seafood platter.
A pleasure. Thank you.